Last time on the Okie Tex Star Party.
This feels like that scene in Jurassic Park where they're like loading the Velociraptor.
So here we are, the Okie Tex Star Party, 2018. We got some rain.
It's hail.
Oh no. Look at the ruts.
Thank you.
Have started to come out, so I'm gonna put a little
PC on. Oh yeah.
Are you you're all collimated up or
yeah,
not?
Yeah, yeah. Ready for you to do it. Finish up the.
Wow. So it's a little knob that you push around, huh?
It's no longer push buttons. So you want it to go that way. So you press on this corner. Yeah, like that.
Oh wow! Look at that. I'd say that's about right there. Wow. Onboard collimation.
Yep.
No more walking to the. Can I just dangle that, or is
it? Dangle it. Yeah.
I mean, no more walking to the back.
Or just drop it here. Magnet.
Oh wow.
So we got rid of the four buttons. Now it's an 8-vector joystick. Yeah. Thumbstick. Yeah.
And then you don't even. You turn the tube towards you up here.
Right.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
That is such a weird image that it's casting on there, but that's the center dot being cast on that white disc from the mirror down here. That's just the donut, that little circular donut shape. Mm-hmm. Being cast right there. And now this telescope is perfectly aligned. Thank you, Howie Glatter. We miss you, buddy.
God rest your soul.
Yeah, man. I think I'm getting the central star. Maybe. We're at peak brightness on everything. I've got the phone maxed out. Night vision's maxed out. And you said we're at 250 power?
Yes.
And I'm 3.2 times zoom. We'll be right back.
Eyesight is incredible.
Yeah, thank you.
Good genetics, I guess. I don't know. There it is. You got it visually, huh? Are you connecting these scopes through interferometry, Don?
No, actually I'm shooting narrow band and one shot color both at the same time.
Uh-huh.
So it's 66 millimeter William Optics SD doing the narrow band and a Red Cat Williams Optics Red Cat 51 for the one shot color.
On a DSLR, huh?
Yep.
Oh, there you go.
50D and on an EM200 mount.
There you go.
Yep. So hopefully I can get it all in a lot quicker, you know, doing it, shooting with two scopes and two cameras at the same target.
That's pretty interesting. Nice. Is this an RC?
Yes.
It's a 10?
Yes.
Okay. 10-inch RC. Oh, that's the Orion mount, huh?
Okay. Yeah, that's the big Orion one.
Yeah, the biggest of the big.
Well, pretty good size.
Well, as far as Orion goes, it's the...
It is. It's her biggest one, yeah.
Yeah. Polemaster, gotta have it.
Yep. That's what I'm doing right now.
I love the Polemaster. I use it on my Atlas. It's money.
Yeah. It takes care of things.
Yeah, the third one, I don't think it's a 3-2 or something.
They're doing a daytime pass.
There we go. Well, I'm gonna let it drift a second. It's picked up speed. It's moving at, I think, 11 knots now. Yesterday, or 2 days ago, it was over here in this sky.
Yeah.
And then yesterday we saw it all the way down there. And then it blew all the way back up here. It's got a FAA tail number, November 103 Whiskey Victor.
You saw
Victor.
That?
Yeah.
Or you looked it up?
Yeah, I looked it up.
Okay, you didn't see it
all. No, I couldn't read it. Hell yeah. It's a 22-inch, man. What are you talking about?
I know.
But no, yeah, it's you can. It was on a flight radar app, free radar app that you can get, and it was it said just showed a balloon. Click on it, shows the tail number, all that. I think it was launched on September 7th. That's what I've been reading.
Oh, and
it's because the star's gonna pop out from right behind the balloon. There it is, boom.
I got it. Yep, right, going by, right by the balloon now.
volume. Yeah, it can't. It can't ever. It's still there. Something beeping.
Somebody sprayed Lysol on their camper and it's making their CO2 alarm go off. Oh yeah,
we've done that.
Dude,
we've done that exact thing.
I know.
Lysol will make
somebody's
your...
Somebody's like, is it on fire? And he's like, I just sprayed Lysol.
We had Warner at Starlight Instruments make adapters for this and for the 3-inch carpet.
Yeah. need to do here is import that final sequence we were just looking at. Thank you.
Yeah, I saw those. I just bought a set.
They're camping at a star party.
Oh, you guys are out camping?
Yeah. And brew with me because I was like, no, we're doing this coffee thing.
I understand.
But there is no doubt these CMOS cameras are the way of the future. And the way of the future is for two reasons. Cell phones. Now, the downfall is they have tiny pixels. And you would think tiny pixels are good. No, tiny pixels are bad. Big pixels are good.
It may not be $100,000, but wow. If you do RV hookups and a little patio and an ice machine and all that stuff down there, it certainly could get up there. So if anybody wants to think about that in the future, that's probably a couple of years down the road. Right? Did I cover everything? Okay. Now, we are going to get into the door prices. Right?
Sky Atlas here, 2000. Summer Lamb, the lambs are in there. She wins every year, Robin Rhodes, come on down. Gil Machen. Michael Gorman. Michael, come down. Celestone Power Tank. Oh. And that will go to Don Town. Congratulations, Don. Laurel Brown, Zach Forlove, and that will go to Courtney Young. Courtney Young.
She's coming.
Come on down, Courtney. Michael Ruse, James Edlin, Leroy Falcon, Will Varnell, Edgar Underhill, Kevin Brown, Rodney Ferguson. This goes to Jory Odom. Bronski. Yeah. Yeah. Congratulations, dear. Jonathan Talbot.
Thank you.
Cat's Paw Nebula.
On iPhone video.
And an iPhone, yeah. It's amazing what you can do with cell phones these days with the proper equipment.
Yeah, well, we're shooting under that cloud.
Yeah, there's a cloud.
We're between the cloud and the ground.
NGC something or other.
Something or other.
Shooting. Will, where are you going to be posting all this at?
YouTube.
Okay.
There she goes. Look at this. Rex found us a UFO.
A constellation satellite. So you want to see this? These are not the little ones that we see on the ground.
And this is in the Cygnus area, you said, Ed?
Gamma Cygna.
Gamma Cygna, and it's just a little dark nebula in here that's like one of those pillars or whatever. There's my smudge. Cool.
No parents gonna show that to
me. Yeah, I'm gonna have to take the audio out of this one.
Y'all know that Beavis and Butthead are 25 years old.
Oh man.
Gosh, can you believe that?
So that's where the smudge is.
Pretty sure that's what it was. But it was big. I mean, I hit it just perfect.
Pac-Man Nebula.
It's illuminated, too.
It looked like the mothership.
It did.
Okay,
yeah.
That's
what it was.
Yeah.
Waka.
The first time we saw...
Messier 31.
You just hand-holding it over that?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Getting all these nebulas and stuff posted.
You got your iPhone. I mean, you got it set up a certain way to be able to.
Look at that. Pleiades. Shimmer it's doing in there. Those EL wires or the carbon fiber or fiber optics on those red. That's I like that going up the guy wires right there. That's really cool. That's pretty neat. Thank you.
Do something cool, Bram. That was pretty cool.
How do you do, neighbor?
Down by the river. Oh, I just saw a meteor. I just got one in here. You have plenty of time to observe the sky when you're living in a van down by the river. How's the chili?
It's pretty good. It's a sweeter chili, but I like it.
Well, good. We're getting video of you eating chili at a Bortle 1 site.
Yeah.
For no reason. Thank you.
great.
Yeah, oh, yeah, absolutely. For that was cool.
For eyepieces. I don't have to worry about it blowing, the wind blowing off the table. The wind blows that over, we're in trouble.
Thermonuclear viewing device.
Well, would you like to drive her up and down the road a little bit?
Yeah.
Yeah, Ed, you should have enrolled it in the dog show.
Now, is the entire frame aluminum?
Yes, it is now.
Okay.
The original one was steel.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but then when I went to the track system, it added another 30, 35 pounds over the wheels, and it was getting too heavy, so.
Actually, the email's already on the card.
Okay.
Start to DA and then, of course,
at least half of it.
Yeah, at least half of it, yeah. Yeah, where are we?
One goes, $10 goes for food, $10.
Yeah, so. And they have batteries, the batteries are on the back here. They're button 2032 button batteries.
Can you turn on again for me, Derek?
Oh.
There you go. That is very cool. And it has a side for white, huh?
Mm-hmm. Yep. There's three settings on the white. But on the red, you only need one,
right,
obviously.
Of course,
so,
yeah.
And they're purposely under here so that they're actually not in someone's eyes. Mm-hmm. You know, that, and it also helps you, you know, it looks obviously exactly down to where you want to look at.
Yeah.
You know, so.
You know, you get a different brightness, which is probably not meant to be that way.
Yeah.
But he figured it, and whatever, he told me something.
Thank you.
for the final command sequence to observe Pluto. We have to program the spacecraft ahead of time and give it all its precise details, like turn 10 degrees here. So luckily, at the head of our team of operations, we have Alice Bowman here. And our spacecraft is set to
Okay, we're going to try to jump right into our final giveaway. If you have not,
why must?
David Spillman. G, congratulations. Lario Urino. Peter Ishman. And this goes to Jill Johnson. William LeMay. Doug Jones. Darlene Davis. Rick Smith. Gordon Pegg.
Yes!
Congratulations. Chance Fryerberg. The Fryhover family is cleaning up. John Anderson, Kathy Anderson. Come on in, Brian. There he comes. Congratulations. Dean Schwartzenberg. Dean Schwartzenberg. Go to Art Schneider. Rosalind Rowe Jones. To Paul Sarowski. I'll spell it. Paul Surowiec. That's free. Odom.
He's gone.
Jory Odom. Jory Odom. Lackluster. Goes to Bentley Owsley. Stephen Chapman. Mike Mitchell. Paul Anderson. Paul, congratulations. And that goes to Stephen Eshman. Michelle Bloom. Another in the dark. Come on in, Michelle. Bill Christian. Congratulations, Bill. Sean Grant. Clifford Talbot. Martha LeMay. Greg Dillon. Adam Koloff. Thank you.